Hello everyone, welcome back to Sim Airport. Now, I know I didn't release a video yesterday, but that's because, well, if you follow me on Twitter, you would know. I ended up biking 11 miles yesterday, and I was a little bit tired from doing that, so I just sat and streamed on Twitch for a little bit. But here we are having a video today. Now, there won't be any more videos again until next week, but that's just because of, you know, scheduling and the weekend and all that kind of fun stuff. So today, though, we are going to get baggage claim taken care of because this is just a frickin' mess trying to get all these carts in and out of here and people coming out trying to claim their bags, but people trying to go. I mean, it's just total chaos. I hate it. It's driving me absolutely insane. So I've let the game fast forward a little bit, and we've got $125,000 saved up. I've actually paid back about $200,000 in the bank loan, maybe $150,000 to $200,000, something like that. Ew, looks like I've got some trash in here. Probably need to get a janitor. Actually, let me hire a couple more of them. So what I want to do, and what I've already done a little bit, is I've already moved the pickup zone, and I have kind of sketched out what I would like baggage claim to look like. So we have, it's actually a pretty decent sized baggage claim for just these 1, 2, 3, 4 gates. But I was looking at this, and I might be able to expand this just a little bit eventually. Depending on the direction that we go with the airport and everything, and how we expand this, it's very possible that I could take this area and extend it down this way, and maybe add. I was thinking about adding another one of these in, like right there. But I'm gonna get stopped from that because this is not going to be able to really go much further. It's just not. So I don't know. There's some design things that I really need to think of when it comes to this airport and once we start expanding and everything else. So, but I do want to make sure that I'm utilizing this. So it's very, very possible that instead of expanding north like I usually do, since I can expand from all directions now, it's very possible that I'll expand south and west, just so I can kind of keep the structure of what I have of this airport so far. Yeah. So anyway, let's get into what I want to do today. So I definitely want to get baggage claim in here. I don't want to wait anymore. Even after our midnight expenses, we still have $113,000. So I should be able to, let's get the foundation in there. And then, ooh, that's going to be $187,000. Okay, not a big deal. I don't need all of this right away, but I really do think that I need at least that much. Yeah. Yeah, I need at least that much. So $100,000, not bad. Let's go ahead and clear that out since we can do that now. And actually, what I want to do is I want to move the security exit over here. Let me do this. Let's pause the game real fast. And I want to build a wall there. So I'm basically going to kind of make it to where these people can't exit yet. So we'll build a wall there. By the time they get done with this, they should be up to doing that. I just don't want to spend the extra money. You know, I want to make sure I can dismantle that security exit, make this whole thing secure, and yeah. So let's put the door there. We will say, let's clear that. Let's see, can I clear that out of there? Yep, sure can. Which of course, now that they can't exit there, they will, you know, they'll find a way out is what will happen. problem is that I don't know if this is actually secure or not. Alright, security exit. I'm honestly surprised this hasn't gone saying that it's not secure. It's very interesting. Cause you would think you think that would happen, but it didn't. But alright, whatever. Alright, let me get rid of this part at least. Okay. Oh no! No, that's alright. I'm like, I got rid of where my things are going. It's okay. It'll be alright. It'll be fine. They go right in the middle. So if I go 5 by 3, I think that's where I wanted it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. And that one can go... No. That one can go there. Yeah, that's how I want that to go. Okay. So we'll have the baggage carousels here. And I'm gonna have... I was looking at this earlier. So baggage claim, I need to... Let's see. Not planning. Queue zones. Oops. Oops, 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 oops. Nope. Security... Put that back where it belongs. Okay. Eventually this will end up being security. I don't want to change it just yet. Baggage claim is now going to be here. Okay. So here's baggage claim. And then... So what... The issue that we're going to have is that I can't expand the foundation out this way any because of the taxiway. I thought about taking the belts and going in this direction with it, but I don't like that idea. Since I have this huge area open right here, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a small section, and I've got... If I wall this off to, say, there. Actually, let me go a couple more. And let's go wall there. Hopefully that'll deter people from going in that direction. I don't know why they're going that way, but they are. It's weird. Let me go ahead and place a wall there as well. So what I'm thinking and what I want to do is I want to take all of these objects, utilities, conveyor. Okay. So I want to take these conveyors and I want to go this direction. Hook all of those up to that. So then what this is going to end up doing is we'll go underground here. So let me grab my planning tool here. So underground here, let's go down. And then this is where we're gonna start off at. So what I wanna end up doing is the baggage depot, utilities, baggage depot, right? Yep. So the baggage depot needs to come over here. And if... There we go. Alright, so baggage depot needs to go here. Now, if I'm looking at this correctly... I've got... Outbound there, inbound up there. I'm trying to remember, I don't know exactly how big this thing is. 2 by 7? Baggage depot. Oh my god, I'm actually right. Haha! It's awesome! Alright, so if I do 2 by 7, and if it goes there, let's do a medium hanger. Do I want a medium hanger, or do I want a small hanger? Yeah, I want a medium hanger. I think we'll go ahead and put a medium hanger in right there. How much did that cost me? 30,000? Eh, it's not bad. Not bad. Alright, so we'll do medium hanger there. And then, let's see, a foundation needs to be underneath this. So, how big do I really want to make this foundation? 7 by 13? That might be too big. I think if I do two on each side... So if I go 1, 2... 1, 2... Okay, if I go 2... And then... Like that. Okay, yeah, that works. So we'll go down. That'll be our foundation for there. Now, I'm gonna have... Oh, I need a conveyor belt going in one direction and another going in a different direction. So if I come down out of here, I can actually use a two-way. No, I can't. If I use a two-way going this way, then I have to have another hub down here. I could actually do that. I could do that. How big is... The biggest thing with this, doing baggage now, is you have to make sure that you have this in an in-ground area. So it can be a bit of a challenge. It really can be. But I think if I take this, and if I go here with it, it'll give me an in and out on the right. It'll give me a double side on the top and the bottom. Granted, I can change those, but if I... Okay, so if I put this here... I'm looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by 3. Okay, I'm having to put my finger on the computer screen right now so I can keep track of this. All right, so that... is the corner of it. So 3 by 5. So that would be my depot. This would be the sides of it. Or not the depot, the hub. So the hub is there. Depot here. I have... Okay, it actually needs to be this big. So that stuff can fit around it. So if I have the line going this way, so then that would mean this needs to come out to here. Okay. So blue is gonna be, so I should make this blue is my wall, and then yellow is blue is going to end up being my wall. Yellow is the open space. And then in order for me to connect this to here, I'm thinking I might as well go ahead and... Let's see, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that's fine. So let's just make our wall come out to here. And then we'll just fill this whole thing in. Whole thing will be like that. The depot is gonna be, and what I found out is that if you're, when you're doing this and you're planning, right? So if you go and highlight this, and then if you go down to the next level and then release, pops it right in there for you. Just found that out not too long ago. I love that feature. I think it's awesome. It's made planning pretty darn easy. All right, so we have this huge area right here. I'm thinking maybe I move this just a little bit closer. If I go, let's keep it 1, 2, 3, 4 apart. And if I go 5, 3, then I should be able to take the wall over to there. That way I'm not having to spend nearly as much money. So there we go. So then we have the hub, and we have that. And this can actually come straight down and into here. Instead of me doing a back and forth, we'll come straight down into here, go up to there, come into here. Unless I can fit one, two, three. Nah, I can't really fit a hub in there. I'd have to make that area bigger. I don't like that. But then what I can do next is this can come out this way. And then baggage claim is going to be, what, somewhere down here? Is that right? Yeah, baggage claim is going to be here. Let's go there. 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 All right, so baggage claim is going to be there. The... That'll be there. So then this probably just needs to come straight down. I'm gonna have to have another baggage hub down here. So if I put, how am I gonna do this? Because if these can't cross paths, I'm gonna have to have, let's do white. I'm gonna have to have one hook up into here like this. One will have to hook up into here like that. And then the other will have to hook in here and go like that. So then that means this wall has to expand out to at least there. Okay. Let's go ahead and use white for my connection here. So we'll do that. Oh, as you can see, just by planning this out, it has become, I mean, I've spent, you know, 15 minutes just trying to plan this out here. So, this is a bit crazy. But it will definitely be worth it in the end. Now, if I have, let's see, so 3x5, that's perfect. So I can have this one hooked up to that end. That will be hooked up to that, and that'll be hooked up to that. And then this can come into it here. And then to make all of this room, I'll need walls coming this way. Oh wait, didn't I say blue is wall? Sorry. Blue is the wall. Granted, I know I have walls, but, you know, whatever. So we'll have that go there. And then... Let's see, I think we'll keep that like that. We'll have this come out to there. One, two, three. So then we'll just make that all, yeah. Okay, so that'll all be foundation. That'll be foundation, foundation, foundation. Okay, not bad. Took me a little bit longer than what I thought I was gonna do, but I think we're pretty good. I think that shall work. So let's just get the foundation in here and get this bad boy moving. All right, everyone. So it appears to be working fairly well right now. I already have gotten, the baggage set up for this, and we are going in very, very nicely. We want to make sure, though, that... Let's go ahead and slow the game down here real quick. We need to add a couple of vehicles, so let's add 2 baggage cars. And then I need to take this, and we need to assign it to A1 and B1. And that should be... must be assigned to an aircraft gate. Yep. Okay, so we have it assigned to an aircraft gate. Perfect. Now, last thing that we need to do is we need to get this area down here constructed. I was waiting for some money to build up because, as you saw, $90,000 for that. And then it's going to be $108,000 to get that taken care of. So a little bit expensive, however, totally going to pay off in the end because it's going to make our lives so much easier. It really, really is. So let's get the conveyor belt down in there. Thought about taking out a little bit of an extra loan to get this taken care of, but I'm not going to do that. Not going to do that at all because I don't want to. I'm trying to pay this money back. So let's just kind of keep it where it is, all right? Now, I will say that while we're waiting on that to be done now, so there was a suggestion made by... Who was it? Let me pull it up real quick. The suggestion was made by Rusty Walker. So, Rusty, thank you very much for the suggestion. He has suggested that we put a walkway, a moving walkway in, but only for the departure passengers, not for the arrivals. So the ones that are coming into the airport and leaving the airport off of the planes, we don't need to add that in there. But those that are coming in, that are going to the plane, especially over here in this area, to go ahead and put a moving walkway in. I think that's a brilliant idea. Hopefully I'll be able to do that very soon if I have the money. I'm really, really hoping that I can. So we'll see. I would really, really like to add that in here. But like I said, we'll see how that goes. In the meantime, really, really enjoying seeing how this is operating right now. So I love the baggage stuff that they do now. It used to be a big pain in the butt, and they've changed it. The devs have changed it a couple of times. I personally think that this is probably the best one that they've done, you know, when it comes to in terms of setup and stuff like that. Even though it's a bit of a pain in the ass to build the foundation underneath, I still like it, you know. It's realistic, it's more practical, you know. So, as much as I may not like it sometimes because of the expense of it, it's realistic, you know? So, that's all I gotta say about that now. All right, let's make this one. Oh, I can't do anything with that yet. And I need to construction, clear that out. And while they're building that up, let's go ahead and get rid of this planning crap because it always gets on my nerves when I forget to clear this out of here. Pardon me, I just burped. I don't know why. Oops. My bad. I don't want to get rid of any of this stuff yet, though, because I need to know where my crap is going. So let's see. Let's go construction, clear. Let's get that out, and then I should be able to baggage carousel. I think this is the direction that I want to go in. Yes, that is the direction I want to go in. Woo, good. All right, let's see, is that is in here now? Okay, so we will, no, that is not, what? I mean, it's not in there. Oh, I have to right click. Duh. God. Okay, objects, no, utilities, conveyor, so we'll hook the conveyor up to there, to the consumer, and we'll take the producer there, take this producer down to here, and we're good to go. We've got it hooked up. I'm not going to worry about building this third one just yet. I think we're going to wait on that. I think we will wait, yeah, we will wait on that one. So let's go ahead and clear that out, go back down. And we'll clear at least that out for now. Don't have to worry about the rest of that, so that's fine. So, there you go. Simple, basic conveyor system. Obviously, it's going to get a lot more complicated once we, get a little bit busier in this airport. But for now, this will be fine. I am very curious to see how we're going to be able to finagle this a little bit later on. But, you know, it works. I like it. Let's see, it's 10:19 a.m. Don't want to do that yet. Next episode, we're definitely going to work on the research aspect and working on getting the C-suite taken care of, you know, with the CSOs, CEOs, COOs, and all of those fun people. I keep hitting the wrong frickin' button. All right, let's repay back some of this. I'd really like to get a lot of this repaid back. I think what I'll work on is getting, this loan paid back in full in between this episode and the next. And then just getting some extra cash flow in here. That way we're good. Yeah, that way we are definitely good on cash and not having to, you know, wait around too much. And then kind of go from there. I think that, this runway, this runway is getting ready to be very, very busy because I would really like to add in our third gate in here now that we have a baggage depot. But I'm also going to have to sit down and start looking at some planning too to kind of see what we're going to do next, like fully. And try and figure out how this is exactly gonna go, you know? Anyway, I'm thinking of stuff in my head, and yet I want to tell you, but I don't want to tell you because I want to keep it a little bit of a secret and keep you in suspense for some more. Anyway. So, that is all I have for you guys today. Like always, questions, comments, concerns, put it in the comment section down below. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell to get notified on when I upload videos. I am hoping to start doing some live streams here on YouTube in a little while, maybe within the next week or two. So, tell me what games that you have seen on the channel that you might like to see me stream on here. You know, just take a look. What do you think I should stream? This, should I stream Sim Airport? Should I do City Skylines? Should I do Factorio or Academia? What is it that you guys are interested in seeing me stream? Let me know in the comment section below. Other than that, I'm gonna shut up because I'm going over my time now. So that is all I have for you guys today. Thank you for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time.